The next, we're going to talk about the 45-degree line. So what is the meaning of the 45-degree line? The 45-degree line is this. When you are on this line, then the distance from this line to the horizontal axis is equal to the distance between this line and the vertical axis. So the length here is equal to the length here. Now we're going to put the 45-degree line together with our consumption schedule. So at intersection, you can see it's here. That means, hey, on this point, your disposable income is exactly equal to your consumption. How so? Well, that's the definition of the 45-degree line, right? When you're on the 45-degree line, that means the distance here is equal to the distance here. Therefore, your disposable income is exactly equal to your consumption. So your DI1 is equal to C1. Now, suppose we are on the point of the consumption schedule that is away from the 45-degree line. So for example, if we are here, then we know that because we are not on the 45-degree line, and therefore your disposable income DI2 is not equal to C2. And in particular, in this case, you can see that our DI2 is greater than C2, meaning our disposable income is higher than our consumption. In fact, if you're on this consumption schedule and you're on the right-hand side of the 45-degree line, that means your disposable income is greater than the consumption. Now let's take a look at another point, the red point on the consumption schedule. Here you can see quite clearly that our disposable income is lower than our consumption. Therefore, you can come to a conclusion that as long as we're on the consumption schedule at the left-hand side of the 45-degree line, then we know that the disposable income is lower than your consumption, meaning you're saving.